Hi, Professor. This is Tracy Thompson, speaking from CSS. I just got done talking to the state, and what you have to do is you have to contact Westchester County for your Medicaid to get it transferred here. We can't do a thing. There isn't such a thing as emergency Medicaid. You have Medicaid, and so does your mother. Louisa has Medicaid, but because
Hello? Hello?
Good afternoon, Social Services.
Good afternoon, this is Professor Martinez. May I speak to Tracy Thompson, please, the supervisor? Good afternoon. This is Professor Martinez. You called.
Hi.
Hi. You
I
called
just
and
called
I turned.
You.
Yes, I turned off the machine, but you hung up.
Oh, I'm sorry. I kept hearing I heard a screech in my. I thought, oh boy, the message is done. Okay, so I spoke to the state and our Medicaid supervisor, and your mother has to work with Westchester County to get the Medicaid transferred here. Now, apparently, there was a string call. Do you know anything about that?
Your mother? There was what?
A fair hearing?
Yes, they, when she refused to sign the certification for her Medicaid, so the illegal aliens that are using her Medicaid and her identity could continue to use it. The criminal Department of Social Services commissioner of Westchester County, Kevin McGuire, got somebody to impersonate her, apparently, and that got that person asked for a fair hearing. And apparently that person went to that fair hearing and continued to impersonate her. They continued with their falsification of records. But when the fair hearing occurred, she was already living in Livingston County because she moved into Livingston County the 5th of March, 2016. And I believe the false fair hearing, quote unquote, was the 19th of March.
Okay. So you have to call Westchester County. You're both getting Medicaid, but it's all done through a quick transfer. It like takes a day or so. Once they know where you're living and your address, then you will transfer it here. Now, however, your mother's Medicaid is going to get hung up because of that fair hearing. She's going to stay there until that fair hearing is done.
The problem is that she cannot control a criminal who has been selling illegal aliens the identities of USA citizens and their government benefits for 25 years. She's an elderly, disabled, and chronically ill citizen who is dying of cancer as a consequence of his trafficking of citizens' identities and government benefits. So it is impossible for citizens who are elderly and disabled like her to control a criminal who is getting people to impersonate the citizens and get and ask for fair hearings that are illegal in the first place. They are invalid fair hearings because the person never asked for them. That is just a strategy for the Department of Social Services, traffickers of citizens' identities and government benefits to continue to steal the benefits and sell them. So, you know, it is impossible for her to do that. Well, you have had the paperwork for a week now because the 18th of April 2016, we were in your office and we gave the documentation that proves that Luisa Oyarzun and myself communicated with Kevin McGuire's office and faxed them our written request to close our cases. And we also communicated to your supervisees at your Livingston Department of Social Services that he was not going to close the cases because he's making a lot of money using our identities, and he's not going to stop selling our benefits, government benefits, our Medicaid, food stamps, and whatnot. So,
have you used your Medicaid hard card in Livingston County yet?
Excuse me?
Doctor at all? Have you used your Medicaid county or card here in this county yet?
You're asking me, or you're saying you like Luisa Yasun?
No, I'm just saying because you both get Medicaid, so I'm just asking you.
No. Luisa Yasun doesn't have Medicaid. The illegals in the country who are impersonating her and were sold her identity are using her Medicaid. She hasn't used her Medicaid.
Okay, I can't do anything about that, though. I'm sorry. You're going to have to get it figured out in Westchester County. And at the very least, a phone call or your address so they can transfer your Medicaid.
The problem is that you have the documentation that shows that we asked the Westchester County Department of Social Service commissioner to close our cases, and you stamped those documents, which are in the form of two faxes, faxed to the said commissioner and the said criminal, and he's refusing to close our cases. So how can you ask the USA citizens to force criminals who are working for the government to stop doing falsification of records? That's like if you ask a police officer, if you're a police officer and somebody's being raped, you have to ask your rapist
to
stop raping you.
It's
really strange that it's breaking up now, because you were listening to me very clearly until now.
I was trying to, yeah.
Okay.
I couldn't hear it. It was going worse. So wherever you're standing now, I can hear you.
Well, the problem is that if you're a police officer and somebody's being raped, you cannot ask the person to ask the rapist to stop.
What?
You know, and that's exactly what you're doing to Luisa Yarton, this elderly and chronically ill citizen who needs her Medicaid to get medical treatment for her cancer and other illnesses. And you're saying, well, you have to force Kevin McGuire, the criminal that has been stealing your Medicaid and your government benefits, to stop.
You guys have Medicaid. You can go to the doctor.
We do not have Medicaid. And as you know, it is illegal for us to use the government benefits of one county when we do not live in that county. That's a crime.
You have to go through Westchester County. We can talk for 3 hours on this.
Yes, the problem is that you know that we cannot do anything. You said you have to go through Westchester County. We can't go to Westchester County. We have been going through Westchester County for the last 10 years, and they don't stop the falsification of records and the selling of the citizens' identities. Okay, well, Luisa Yasun is dying of cancer, and you're saying, you know, I'm the person to process her paperwork and stop this criminal from killing her, and you're saying, no, I'm not going to do anything.
We don't have any proof or any verification about any agencies. We don't have anything. I don't know what that is.
You don't have any proof? What about the federal lawsuit that you have a copy of? What about the Medicaid that Luisa Yarton has opened? You yourself told me that the case is open in Westchester County. Why is that case open in Westchester County when she's living in another county, in Livingston County? That's proving itself. I'm looking at you, you're a woman, but I don't have a proof that you're a woman. What you're saying doesn't make sense. No, Luisa Oyasum do not have Medicaid. She hasn't been treated. That's why her cancer came back a third time. Okay, you are saying that she called a fair hearing. You're working with Kevin McGuire because you're saying that she called a fair hearing. And I just explained to you that Kevin McGuire had somebody to impersonate her and call for a fair hearing when she was already in Livingston County. How is she going to ask for a fair hearing when she was 8 hours away by driving? It doesn't make any sense. What you're saying doesn't make sense. No, what you're saying is that you won't help her with her Medicaid because
I can't. Because
no, you can. You can open the case and you can give her an emergency Medicaid so she can get the
emergency Medicaid. If you look up in the regulations, there's emergency Medicaid systems here. People have to come in here and see the Medicaid counselor and see it might be a day or two, but we don't have anything on the spot. Somebody can't just walk in here and say, I demand emergency Medicaid because, I have to go to the doctor. No, we don't do that.
I'm not saying that I'm demanding anything. I'm saying that you are a state employee and you're supposed to process the paperwork of elderly and chronically ill citizens who need medical care, and they cannot get this medical care. This medical care, can I speak? Because I let you speak. Ms. Thompson, I let you speak. Can I speak now? Thank you.
You spoke through all I was speaking. But yeah, speak now.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
I appreciate it. What you're saying is that we weren't there demanding anything. We were not there demanding anything. We were there to fill out the paperwork, which we did, and you guys are refusing to process that paperwork with an excuse that doesn't make sense. You're saying somebody is impersonating you and somebody's committing a crime, and we agree with that crime. You have to go and stop that crime, which you don't have the power to do, for me to process your paperwork and give you the government benefits that you're entitled to have legally. That's what you're saying.
My turn?
Yes.
So what I'm saying now, and I've said it already, I wish I could help her and you. I wish I could make
no,
her.
No, 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 no. You're not helping her. You have a misconception, Ms. Thompson.
Okay.
You are doing your job. You are processing the paperwork because you're a state employee who is paid to process the citizens' paperwork so they can get their government benefits, and you're refusing to do so with a very lame excuse. You're saying that she has to die because somebody else working for the Department of Social Services is continuing to sell her benefits and to defraud the USA government, and that person is above the law, like you are.
Okay, but
that's what you're saying.
But we don't have any proof of where you live. We don't have any ID for birth certificates and social. I mean, there has to be an interview if you're applying for assistance.
Which was performed during the day that I was there. And Ms. Oyasun is in bed, and she's saying in the middle of her pain, because she has the shingles, as you can, as you know, that she lives here in Westchester, in Livingston County. She doesn't have anything to do with what they do in Westchester County, because she's living here and she has the evidence. She has given you the evidence that she, the proof that she lives here.
Sarah is going to put she's denying the Heath case because you didn't verify where you lived.
Okay, you are not denying the heat benefits because of that. You are denying the heat benefits because you want her to freeze to death, and she already has the landlord statement and everything that you guys need 2 days before they are due, because she has until the 28th of April to submit those documents to you, and it is now the 26th of April to submit the documents to you, and she's submitting the documents to you today. And by the way, she hasn't submitted the documents before because she was in the emergency room of the Danceville Hospital in Danceville, New York, twice in 7 days, because that's how sick she is. She's dying of cancer, lung cancer, and on top of that, she got the shingles, a chronic illness that makes your nerve system attack you and cause chronic pain and make men, young men, cry like babies. She's an elderly disabled citizen that has two cancer operations and multiple sclerosis, besides her other illness. And she has the right to have the 10 days that other citizens have to submit the paperwork.
Can I stop you right now for a second?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how this conversation has to be done, okay? Because two very nice voices, too. And that whole curve by calling Westchester County.
Déjame llamar otra vez porque se corta la comunicación. Que ella va a denegar el gas porque la llamaron y le dijeron, yo ya arreglo lo del gas, entonces va a tener que dárselo.
Sí.
Yo le paseo a la comisionada.
Good afternoon. This is Professor Martinez. May I speak to Supervisor Tracy Thompson? I was just speaking with her and we got disconnected.
Sure, one moment.
Good afternoon, Ms. Thompson. This is Professor Martinez. We got disconnected.
Okay.
What were you saying?
I just said that for right now, I can't give you any more information that I've already given you. So there's no sense in, you know, staying on the phone because we're not getting anywhere. But, I mean, the bottom line is that you have to deal and call Westchester County. You know, if, I mean, you make those calls and try to see if you can get it straightened out.
Ms. Thompson, I called Westchester County 6 or 7 times. I have documented that, and they hung up on me. And I also faxed the written request to close my case in any cases that Luisa Oyarzun has over there, and they hung up on me, and they haven't closed the cases. Do you think that because I call them now, they're going to close the cases? If they're making thousands of dollars with her Medicaid, selling it to illegal aliens, and with selling my Medicaid and government benefits to illegal aliens, do you think that because I call them, they're going to close them now?
Well, did you tell them that you moved? I don't know how else to say it. Receive your food stamp case closed, you request it, yes. The Medicaid, however, is transferred, and it's transferred between counties, between Medicaid departments.
Ms. Thompson, she does not have New York State straight Medicaid. Her Medicaid was sold to illegal aliens, and that's why she got cancer a third time, because she didn't get any treatment. Do you really think that somebody's going to let a cancer come back a third time and go through chronic cancerous pain for 5 years?
I'm saying that she has to go through pain. I'm saying I don't have any proof that they've been sold to illegal aliens. I don't know anything about the trafficking.
You don't have any proof? Exactly. You don't have any proof? I'll give you a proof. You yourself told me that they have the open cases there. What are they doing with open cases of people that do not live in that county? Do you think they have that to put them under the under their pillow to go to sleep every night?
When did you move?
As I said, 5 or 6 times. I moved the 5th of March 2016. It is now 28th of April 2016. That's more than 1 month ago, and they already have they continue to have the cases opened. Exactly. I'm getting the food stamps because they have a fraction of my food stamps and Luis Ollarsson food stamps given to us. The other parts of food stamps, they are selling to illegal aliens and illegal aliens mafia members in Westchester County and across the country. So that's why they hung up on me 6 times or 7 times when I called. And they also refused to close the cases when they received the facts, which you have in your office, and also the fax receipt, which shows that they received the facts, requesting for them to close the cases. And you yourself have said many times during our conversation today that you don't have any paperwork that proves that we requested the cases closed. You don't know, check the papers. That's why I gave it to your supervisees. Or you don't check the paperwork that your supervisees do.
Okay, I may have it in the file here.
You may have it. You should have it. That's your job, Ms. Thompson. You have to have your paperwork done. You know what I mean? I mean, I'm a college professor. I cannot tell somebody, oh, well, you gave me your book report, and I don't know where it is. I may have it. I might have it. I might not. I cannot do that. That's my job.
Okay, listen. What do you want me to do right now?
I want her to issue an emergency Medicaid as U.S. law states that should be issued for chronically ill citizens like Luis Ollarsson because she's dying. I thought the other day, about 3 days ago, that she was going to die. She is dying. And I don't understand how... Listen, she has had emergency Medicaid before, so don't even bother telling us that you don't know about emergency Medicaid and there is no, the emergency Medicaid don't exist. Don't bother because we know it's not that way.
We cannot help you. I'm sorry.
So you are not going to give her the emergency Medicaid that she needs to be treated, and you are not going to open any cases knowing that Luis Ollarsson and myself have been living for a month and a half for us.
But you still got the coverage. You still got the Medicaid coverage. So you're not
Ms. Thompson, as I said several times during our conversation today, it is illegal, as you know, to use the government benefits of one county when you live in another. That's basic U.S. law. Ask Mr. Sylvester, you said that you have a lawyer, ask him, he would confirm that.
No,
ask any lawyer, ask any legal, ask any Department of Social Services law specialized person or lawyer, and they will tell you, it is illegal for you to get benefits of one county when you live in another county. That's fraud. And I did, and you have the evidence that I did because your supervisees were given those papers, and I have the faxes stamped by your supervisees saying and showing that they received those faxes that we faxed Commissioner McQuire asking him to close the cases. But of course, he's not going to close the cases because he's making a lot of money. He and the Department of Social Services employees.
I don't have any proof.
What do you mean you don't have any proof? I gave your supervisees the facts showing that we asked for the cases to be closed.
Okay. I cannot do anything for you today. You have to call Westchester County.
And I di- okay, and I did that seven times, six or seven times, and they hung up on me. What is the purpose of me calling Westchester County when they are going to hung up on me, Ms. Thompson? I don't understand. No, you are not sorry. You are enjoying this, Ms. Thompson, because it's not you and it's not your mother who is dying of cancer because of trafficking of citizens' identities by the Department of Social Services employees.
Okay, I'm not suggesting for her to die or anything like that. That's ridiculous. I wouldn't want not anybody to die. Now, you need to call Westchester County, and I know you've called them. And I know they hung up on you.
Seven times, six or seven times.
I can't help you. I can't help you.
Okay, Miss Thompson, if you would not do your job, which is what you are paying for, I cannot force you. I can just give the information to the pertinent authorities and pertinent people and see if they can do something regarding that, because Luisa Oyarzun's cancer has come back a third time because of this said trafficking of citizens' identities and government benefits. And you are basically saying, you know, you are an elderly and chronically ill citizen who is dying of cancer, and you have to force this criminal who has been killing citizens, American citizens, for the last 25 years by selling their benefits and identities to illegals and illegal aliens mafia members to close your cases. Excuse me? Because they have connections. I asked them the same thing. You know what they told me? We have people everywhere, and we have connections. We're not going down. And they also offered me $3 to $5 million for every 5 years if I worked with them, because according to them, I'm very intelligent or very smart. It doesn't occur to them that my intelligence comes from God and is not going to be used ever to do something wrong, like killing American citizens or stealing people's properties or government benefits. I will never do that, ever.
Okay.
They can offer $5 million a year. They can offer $10 million per day. I will not do that.
Okay. Well, there isn't anything more for us to talk about.
So what you're saying is that you're not going to open any cases and you're not going to give us our government benefits because even though we live in your county, you want us to use the benefits of another county.
Yes.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you for your call, Ms. Thompson.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.